Spektrum has been an industry leader in 2.4 GHz technology for a number of years now, with a wide variety of radio systems, modules, accessories, things along those lines. We're here today with Blake Good from Spektrum. Thanks for coming by, Blake.
Oh, you're welcome. Good to be here, Gary.
And the new DX2S radio. Blake, can you give us a brief overview on this new radio from Spektrum?
Absolutely. The DX2S, Gary, is similar to our DX3S, with which most people are familiar with. What the 2S offers that's different is it doesn't have the auxiliary channel, which makes it a two-channel radio, mm-hmm. hence the name DX2S. Also, it doesn't have the throttle punch, which is another feature. But other than that, it's very similar to the DX3S. It has exponential travel, servo reversing, and most of the same features that are on the 3S. What's included with the DX2S out of the box is the SR3300T receiver, which is telemetry compatible, so the DX2S does do telemetry just like the DX3S.
Okay.
Has the same gauges, RPM, speed gauge, and the battery gauge, temperature gauge. And then it also includes a new S100 servo that is it's a heavy-duty servo with metal gears, dual ball bearing, and a pretty good amount of torque. It has about 125 ounce inches of torque.
Dual ball bearing, so there's no bushings in that.
No bushings.
That's actually really good for an included servo. Normally, you know, an included servo you get with the radio, it's a throwaway type item, so that's actually a pretty good value here.
Yeah, it's a pretty good durable servo.
Getting back to the DX2S for a moment then, too, mm-hmm. I mean, it really sounds like it's basically, minus the throttle punch thing, it's really a DX3S minus one channel.
That's right. So yeah, you take away the auxiliary channel, and then we've removed, obviously, the auxiliary functions from the software itself. But it's basically, yeah, it's very similar to the 3S.
Now, one of the things that really makes this popular, and makes the 3S popular for that matter, is the fact that it does include the onboard telemetry. Does this include all the sensors and everything like what the 3S has, or are those now separate?
Absolutely, it does include all the sensors. It includes the brackets, the mounting brackets for the RPM sensor.
Okay.
It includes the RPM sensor itself. It includes a electric motor or battery temperature sensor, plus includes the nitro head temperature sensor.
So really, the main thing is you're getting one fewer channel, no throttle punch. Now, is it one receiver or two? Because the DX3S does come with that S300 sports receiver as well.
Yeah, that's right. The DX3S does come with two receivers. This just comes with one.
But then again, the DX3S has no servo included, so
that's right.
It's kind of a nice balancing act there. Let's talk about the radio itself. It feels like it's pretty much the same case and design as what the 3S mm-hmm. has.
Exactly.
Will the accessories for the 3S work on the 2S, such as the bigger grips or smaller grips or the accessory wheels available from Dynamite?
Absolutely. And this out of the box does include the different grips. The medium one's installed. It includes a small one and a large one in the box. And then the Dynamite wheels do fit, so they fit very well, just the same as the 3S.
Very cool. Now, one thing, too, that we've had as of late is the MR3000 marine receiver. Mm-hmm. Is this marine compatible?
Absolutely, it sure is.
Oh, that's dialed.
Yep, it works with the MR3000 marine receiver plus DSM-2 receivers, just like the new DX3Ss.
So the 3100 and the 3520 will work with the DX2S.
That's right.
All
of our surface receivers work with this transmitter. So you can use this transmitter on the 3100, the 3520, which are DSM-2 receivers,
mm-hmm.
the MR3000, the marine receiver, plus all the DSM receivers like the SR3001, the Pro receiver, the SR300, the SR3300T. Yeah, it works with all the surface receivers.
So then, of course, I mean, I know you guys are going to ask this too. It works with the low C receiver then too, the DSM?
Yes. Yep. It's
awesome.
It's
so it'll do
receiver.
Everything under the sun. What's the model memory on this?
It has 5 model memory.
Okay.
It's a good thing to point out. So the DX3S had 10, this one has 5.
So, I mean, really, but if you're looking, the target audience for this is really the sport guy who's kind of on a budget, maybe has like a T-Max or a Slash or a Revo or something like that, who's looking to upgrade from that kit AM radio system.
Yeah, that's right. It's a great upgrade radio. You know, you get all the benefits and features of having 2.4 gigahertz spectrum, and plus all the features of telemetry as well. So it's a great upgrade radio, and it all comes at a price of $199.99. So.
Well, and then what's nice too with the new, I know Losi's got the Strike coming out in the bind and drive format. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's if you need a radio or something like that, basically this will get you up and running, plus a second receiver if you'd want to install, or an additional receiver since the Strike would come with one, that you could install in something else that you have then too.
Absolutely, yeah.
Let's talk one thing too that has been a bit of an issue on the DX3S, you'll grant me this one here, is this guy here, the roller selector. Some of the early ones had some issues where basically the plastic pin that got pushed into it was, or molded into it, could break. Is this the same roller selector that the DX3S uses? Has it been changed? Has that issue even been addressed?
Yeah, as soon as we saw that some failures on the DX3S, we did address it. We changed the roller design to make it more durable, plus we used a little bit stronger material. And that's been, the DX3Ss have had that new roller for quite some time now.
Okay.
The 2S uses the new design, so it's more durable and is more reliable and won't break.
So let's kind of go through to some of the progression that we've seen thus far in the Spektrum surface radios. First, we had the DX2 and the DX3. Mm-hmm. Then we went DX2.0 and DX3.0, which replaced the 2.0 and or the original DX2 and the DX3.
Right.
Now we have a DX2S and a DX3S. Does that mean the DX2.0 and 3.0 will be going away then soon too?
No, we're going to keep the DX2.0 and 3.0. What we've done recently or earlier this year was we dropped the pricing on the DX2.0 and 3.0 to make them fit into our lineup. So, yeah, we have no plans to discontinue those radios.
Now I have to ask, we have, again, like I mentioned, the DX2.0 and the 3.0. We have a DX2S and a 3S, related yet unrelated. What about a DX2R?
Good question. We have no plans for a DX2R right
now. Okay. So anything else in closing? I mean, this looks like it's very similar to the DX3S. Has all the same basic features, minus the auxiliary, minus the throttle punch. Oh, frame rate on here. That's been a real hot button topic as of late. Is it? Does it have, since it's the DSM-2, does it have the 5.5 millisecond frame rate? Is it just the 11 millisecond? What's the frame rate on this?
The frame rate on the 2S is the same as the DX3S. It comes out of the box at default of 11 milliseconds. You can also change it to 16.5 milliseconds. If you're using some older analog servos, it might not be compatible with the 11 millisecond frame rate.
Well, and that's something too to really be aware of. If you are having issues, I call it a servo flutter, and you and I have talked about this as well. Something like, I know the JR 270.
270, yeah.
Is one of those where if you're running something along those lines, go on to that 16.5 millisecond frame rate, is it?
Yes.
Yep. We'll definitely help take care of that. And quite honestly, it's still plenty quick and responsive, so.
Yeah, absolutely. It works just as well. You do get a little faster performance if you can go to the 11 millisecond, but if not, if you do have the 270 servos, we offer the 16.5 millisecond frame rate as well.
And that's something, it's always good, bench test your stuff before you go out to run the first time. I mean, you'll notice if you've got that issue, it's an instantaneous issue that'll pop up, so you'll know,
right.
Set it to the 16, you'll be good to go. Well, thanks, Blake, for stopping by from Spektrum on the DX2S radio. If you do have any comments or questions about anything that you've seen here today, please feel free to email us at editors@horizonrc.com. Thanks for watching.